Hey guys, this is Endora here to explain. I look better without glasses. All a happy spring equinox. It is the vernal equinox, and I'm here to briefly explain what the pagan holiday of spring equinox, also known as Ostara, is all about. First of all, apologies for the video being kind of grainy. I don't know how to fix that on my laptop, but it gives me kind of like, you know, a charitable, you know, soft filter thing, like Joan Collins always used to insist on having in Dynasty, so there really are no accidents. So here's what it's all about. The spring equinox, like all pagan holidays, tie into astronomically and geologically where we are in the planet, because as is above, so is below, because we are all connected. At Yule, winter solstice, that is the moment when on December 21st, give or take, it differs by a few hours or so each year. The Earth, which has been moving away from the Sun, actually begins to move towards the Sun on winter solstice, the pagan holiday of Yule. That is why the symbolism within paganism for thousands of years before Christianity's advent was all about the goddess giving birth to her son, both S-U-N and S-O-N, because we're moving closer towards the Sun. Vernal equinox today is the time where that momentum is increasing because we are closer to the Sun and the Earth comes back to life from its slumber of winter, because both as planets, our planet Earth, the land, animals, crops, peoples, and souls, we all go through many, many times in existence the cycle of birth, death, birth, life, death, and rebirth. So we're increasing in the point of rebirth as the land comes back to life, crops begin to manifest, flowers begin to bloom, animals, including humans, because we're mammals, start experiencing fertility, both in terms of the all critical reproduction of life and also in terms of coming back into ourselves. We are back towards the Sun. Like all pagan holidays, throughout different cultures and different centuries, there was always different names kind of associated with different deities, but they really tied in almost universally to these milestones, these annual milestones in the astronomy, really, of the world. And one of the ways that spring equinox is known is by being called Ostara, O-S-T-A-R-A. It's also named for the Germanic goddess Oster, E-O-S-T-R-E, for whom the holiday, the Christian holiday of Easter, was actually named, because when they were Christianizing Europe, they co-opted the pre-existing pagan holidays because they wanted to get the people on their side, and the people's like millennia old investments and love of the pagan holidays were far too strong to be overcome. So there was what's called a synchronization, or I think, well, I'm misspelling that, but they basically took the names of pagan holidays and ascribed them Christian undertones. But in the pagan faith, this is named for kind of a pan-global dawn goddess. In Greek mythology, she was called Eos, E-O-S, and her Roman cognate was Aurora, goddess of the dawn, and that impacted the Germanic name of Oster or Ostara. So that's kind of where we are, spiritually and mystically speaking. This is a time to renew ourselves. This is almost the most mystically powerful time of rebirth. It is a time of resurrection. So the co-opting of the name of the holiday for the Easter resurrection of Christ is actually quite apt. But, you know, it's not just about Jesus' resurrection. It's a resurrection of the land. It's a resurrection of the people. It's a resurrection of where we are in our souls. This is a time to do mystical workings or even just spiritual workings. You don't have to be a witch, but it couldn't hurt. Where we can renew friendships, we can renew hope within ourselves, we can eschew things that came from a place of darkness in our souls. We can move forth into the lands and into the lands of people's souls to connect to them. This is a time of planting seeds that will bear fruit. It is a time of creation. And it is, of course, a very joyous time. Because make no mistake, I don't like the glare in my glasses. Oh, but I love the glasses down on the rim of the nose thing. Very, very Maggie Smith. But then again, when am I not? The darkness of winter, the darkness of winter solstice, the darkness of Yule is not evil. It is just different than the periods of the world and the periods of our lives in life. The goddess, and within the goddess, both her female and male divine aspects are always with us, even during the dark and cold times of the years and of our lives. But that's not what this time is. This is the time of light and love and rebirth, and more than anything else, and I need to hear this, this is the time of hope, my darlings. This is the time to come back to ourselves. This is the time to know that no matter what happens in our lives in the periods of cold and darkness, it is give or take, but far more often than we're inclined to think, it is truly inevitable that we will move back towards the light, and we will move back towards the warmth, and we will move back towards the creation. So, I'm sorry my Facebook is dinging as I'm recording this, but that's kind of what it's all about, and this is also the holiday that is the almost halfway point between the Yule winter solstice and Beltane, which is coming up on May 1st, which is the great holiday of huge fertility. So we'll talk more about that on May 1st, dumplings. And I hope you enjoyed learning a little bit about what the pagan or one of the pagan approaches towards spring equinox is all about. And also note, this is the time, not just of the goddess, but within her, the god aspect, this is the time when the Oak King is increasing in his prominence. We'll talk more about that on another holiday, on another Sabbath, out of the 8 Sabbaths of the Wheel of the Year in paganism, at another time at Beltane. Happy spring, my darlings. Here comes the sun.